wakes up, ties his headband tight and sharpens his blades up. I shouldn't have said he woke, cause he couldn't sleep, so he stayed up in the moonlight. The air is a cool night, he takes it in and savors it. Casinos once dawns upon us, we take revenge. They tax it to the max, and we was close to breaking then. Now they brazenly taking lives, think it's time to make amends. He's thinking me of them, after the day, may his blade not raise again. He thinks about his son as he begins to pray, today's the end. Half the men are bandits, murder, plunder, and pillage. Nothing but death and famine and anger running this village. Even the children stealing, bellies are never filling. And women selling their bodies for some coin to get a meal with. Surely the cause is man, how could the gods will this? Our doctors don't have meds to stop the spread of simple illness. We struggle for what we have, they call it tax and come and steal it. And if we don't pay them half, they'll set a fire where the field is. Grab my legs to drown the sound and don my black attire. We're outnumbered 5-1, the situation's that dire. But half of us hail from Iga with liars who kill for hire. They leave us living in hell, I give them baptism by fire. How could they think they could leave so little to eat while this tyrant's committing violence in the middle of the street? How could they not perceive they would meet the bitter defeat? Did they think we were so little? Did they think us so weak? He takes one last look at his life. His wife and son never woke him as he strode into the red rising sun. The battle shakes it in, but he's prepared to wait for days for the moment that his opponent would dare to look away. And he's been speaking to the people, he sort of carries the flame. And as he meets up with the gang, about 100 shout his name. He can feel the need for change, it's coursing through every vein. Composure in his pacing face, a storm was raging in his brain. Yo, intel's confirmed, convoys en route. There's really nothing left to say, no noise dip out. They take the place and wonder why they have to go this route. Waiting for hours with enough gunpowder to blow the bridge out. Wait, I hear somebody coming, everybody get down. May every man hold his ground, nobody make a sound and sit down. They've been taking so many peers, so many years, who's the bitch now? Soon as they hit the middle, my niggas gon' burn this bitch down. Earth shattered and shrapnel scattered in the explosion. In the midst of the commotion, arrows set the hit in motion. Step forth in one swing, cut two throats. And as I gave the order to go and look over, see the shogun. Damn, only a few men between us, but they be quick to bust a musket. And indeed they got the heaters, but we cannot let them beat us. Some of us gotta bleed, but we still cannot be defeated. Just think of how close our dream is, think of how close my seat is. Fuck it, I'm going through them. Step to the first, slew them. Second got ran through them. When the third rushed my back, we clashed blades, shattered weapons. Still I feel like fuck them, stuck them with the rest. As I stepped in, then he swore he felt the horse just up and kick him in his chest. Looked down, had a couple arrows sticking out his breast. A smile crossed his face, his forehead bore the mark of death. Gripped his broken sword and grabbed the so-called lord by the vest. Plunged it in his neck, but on the bloody muddy slip, tripped over the cliff while never losing his grip. The shogun tried to scream, it was futile the way he kicked. But as he completed his mission, Zeno met his end in bliss.
Scene one, Apple, take one.